This is Top Gamer 007 here. We have a couple of news articles for today. Links to all news articles and timestamps is going to be in the description below. And don't forget, if you like the video, give it a thumbs up and let's get started. Let's get started with amazing Rockstar news. LA Noire is coming to the Nintendo Switch. Rockstar Games has announced system owners will be able to purchase the game on November 14th. LA Noire originally released in 2011. LA Noire for the Nintendo Switch includes the complete original game and all the additional content DLC. Also in this exclusive, this version of the Nintendo Switch version, of course, will include Joy-Con mode with gyroscopic and gesture based controls and HD rumble, and also a new wide and over the shoulder camera angles and a conceptual touch controls for portable detective work. Man, this is amazing. It's great to see Rockstar support on the Nintendo Switch. I hope, man, this is a huge hope for me. Like, LA Noire, I hope this is going to the right step for Rockstar, because I hope that bigger Rockstar games or ports come to the Nintendo Switch in the future, such as GTA 5. Imagine a GTA 5 portable version. It doesn't even matter if it's the Xbox One or the Xbox 360 versions, because it doesn't matter. There is GTA 5, as long as it's a smooth frame rate, it's fine. And it would have been amazing if Red Dead Redemption came on the Switch, or Bully, or those older games. Would have been amazing. It doesn't have to be like Red Dead Redemption 2 anyway to come on the Switch. I would love if the original game could come to the Nintendo Switch. It's not that hard. I know it's not hard to bring Xbox 360 games to the Nintendo Switch, because, well, more RAM, more power inside the Nintendo Switch compared to the Xbox 360. So it's possible for a Red Dead Redemption original port. And I know it's possible for GTA 5 to come to the Switch. So I don't know if it's gonna happen. I hope this isn't the right direction for Rockstar, but I'm still waiting for a PC port for Red Dead Redemption, so I don't know if this will ever come, like Red Dead Redemption come to the Switch. All we could do is wait and see, to see what happened, what will Rockstar do in the future. Let's move on to Super Mario Odyssey news. Super Mario Odyssey official site shows Peach with a crown that looks like Cappy. The main hook for Super Mario Odyssey is Mario's ability to capture enemies, with largely part possible thanks to the new companion Cappy. Mario may not be the only character in the game with a possessed hat accessory. In the new artwork included on the Super Mario Odyssey official website, we'd be able to see Peach with a crown that looks a lot like Cappy. It doesn't seem like Cappy exactly, it seems slightly more feminine appearance. It's a very close resemblance, however. Man, it is possible. I'm gonna say, crazy ideas out here, like, really crazy. It's possible that Peach Crown is Cappy's sister or something like that. Maybe Cappy have no choice to team up with Mario to stop his sister with Bowser tyranny acts or something, or forcing people to do things. Maybe that Mario is working with Cappy because Cappy wants to save his sister or stop his sister, and maybe Mario obviously want to save Princess Peach. I'm gonna say another random idea, that I have a feeling that Cappy's sister is brain controlling Peach, just like if you throw a hat on someone else, you could control it, right? Maybe Cappy could control Peach and making Peach marry Bowser. Like, maybe Peach is the one that proposed to Bowser. It's possible, something like that. I don't know, I'm just saying loose ideas. So let's move on to the VG Bulletin Mini. We got 6 bullets, I'm 100% sure. 6 bullets to go through. So let's get started with Siberia news. Yeah, Siberia. Siberia is coming on the Nintendo Switch, the original Siberia. Siberia 1 is coming on the Nintendo Switch on October 20th. That date applies to both North America and Europe. Let's move on to Resident Evil news. Resident Evil Revelation 1 and 2 will be launching on the Nintendo Switch on November 28th in the West. When I mean the West, I mean North America and Europe. Capcom is including optional Joy-Con motion controls and HD rumble. You can use the right Joy-Con to aim your shots and swing your knives, and flick it up to reload, and shake the left Joy-Con to escape enemies' attacks when grabbed. Also, in North America, the two games will be sold together as Resident Evil Revelations Collection for $40. Let's continue on Resident Evil Revelation news. Resident Evil Revelations, sadly to say, will require 13 gigabytes of free space for digital release. But I feel sorry for everyone that want Resident Evil Revelation collections or you want it digital, because Resident Evil Revelation 2 will be at 26 gigabytes, double the amount of Revelations 1. And even if you get the physical copy, you would require to download 26 gigabytes of free space on your Nintendo Switch, even if it's digital or physical. And since this is 26 gigabytes, it will not fit within the Switch internal memory. A separate micro SD card will be needed if you want to play the game. I'm not even gonna say purchase, if you want to play the game. Let's swim on to Splatoon 2 news. Splatoon 2 update version 1.3.0 full patch notes was revealed. It's so long. This patch notes are so long. If you're interested for the full patch notes, it's going to be in the description below. Let's continue to Splatoon 2 news. Next Splatoon update has been planned for mid-October. The official Japanese Splatoon Twitter and account confirmed the next update is scheduled for mid-October. The specifics wasn't shared, but more adjustments to the weapons is obviously gonna happen. Let's move on to Nintendo news. A new system update has just gone live for the Nintendo Switch. Version 3.0.2 is out for all users. According to Nintendo, online play has been added in Argentina, Brazil, Chile, and Colombia and Peru. The feature is available for free until the pay online service launches in 2018. Also, general system stability improvements to enhance the user experience has been also been implemented. That's everything that's part of the VG Bulletin Mini. So let's move on to the last piece of news of today about Pokemon CEO thinking that the Switch will not be successful before launch. Bloomberg's interviewed the Pokemon CEO Takazuka Hashirahara. I probably butchered the name. As part of the discussion, Hashirahara spoke about he initially doubted Switch success and even told Nintendo as such. In Hashirahara's full words, quote, "I told Nintendo that Switch wouldn't be a success before it went on sale because I thought that in the age of the smartphone, no one would carry out a game console. It's obvious I was wrong. I came to realize the key to a successful game is quite simple. Software with absolute quality leads to sales of hardware. Playing style can be flexible if the software is attractive enough. Currently, it's popular among the early adopters, but there's need to be one more step to attract a wider audience. I see more potential in the Switch, but one shouldn't overestimate its potential." This quote, I'm telling you, this quote tells me that it's obvious that Nintendo forced the Pokemon company to make a Nintendo Switch version for Pokemon game. Before the release of Nintendo Switch, it's obvious that this Pokemon CEO did not believe in Nintendo Switch. Why would he make a core Pokemon RPG of a system he didn't believe in? And they obviously start making the game before the Switch release, right? So he couldn't tell if it's gonna be popular before release. It's obvious. I could tell you guys right now that Nintendo told them they have to. Just like I said before when I discussed that Pokemon would never leave Nintendo. Nintendo told them to do something and they got to do it. I'm telling you. Wow. You just note that he said that the Switch needed one more step to attract a wider audience. It's obviously. What are you trying to pull, Mr. Pokemon CEO? It's obvious that Pokemon is what we need. The Switch needs. Wow, he thinks he's sneaky, man. I could tell he thinks he's sneaky. So, yes, it's about time to end my video. If you like the video, give it a thumbs up. And subscribe and like videos like this one to help expand my channel. And share the video if you think it could for someone else. Comment below about your opinions about these articles. So, this is TalkGamer007, and I see you in the next one. Peace!